Hey everybody, Chance Priest here again for Priest Toy Safari episode 60 something or another, maybe 67. Anyway, I wasn't going to do one because I'm really covered up with stuff to do, building the big 3P toy factory, home of Victory Comics, by the way. Remember y'all, Victory Comics LLC on YouTube, and Facebook, and Instagram, Chance's Toy Collection on Instagram, and Priest Monsters, Aliens, and Superheroes group on Facebook. So man, that's where you can catch me at any one of them places, usually. Anyway, I showed off a picture of this tub, and one of my good buddies, Howard, wanted some pictures, and I thought, well, hell, instead of doing pictures, I'll just do a, that's what actually made me do my very first Toy Safari. As I said, everybody was asking for pictures of a tub. I just took the very first picture I ever did on Facebook. I said, well, I kept starting to try to do pictures. I said, you know what's a lot faster? I just run a little video. And then I had three or four people asking, so I said, well, I'll post the video instead of just sending it to one person or another. And that's the way it all started. Anyway, this stuff's got like Max Toys in it, Mark Nagata stuff, you know, and which is all great. I love that. I bought from him and since, you know, I bought his stuff since it first came out. So anyway, I've got some of that and then just odd and end small figures. So anyway, we'll get to showing them. This is the only big one I have, which is, I can't never remember nobody's name. Y'all know that, but, anyway, he is super cool. And I don't know. I mean, that's just a freaking great, I mean, that is like legendary status great kaiju right there. That's just, he's just a great figure. Now I know Izon, I know that dude. And here's a little one that's glitter. Has a great little header. And he's like black and gold glitter. I like Izon, man. He reminds me of, like a 50s monster. Like a 50s sci-fi monster, you know, from the old 50s stuff. So anyway, I'm sorry, y'all. I've been out working. It's like I'm go from manual labor to cleaning up and then coming in and doing, because we're building this, this toy factory, which we'll be doing vinyls and all that other stuff. So anyway, and of course, 3P, get up. There's a, not a group, but a page, 3P page. So get on that. Anyway, here's an Izon, with wings. Now, I don't know what you call him, but winged Izon. That's what I'm guessing. So here's another one that's winged, and he's like clear, I'm gonna say clear purple. And y'all know, I say it all the time. In fact, one of my good buddies get all over me, you say you're colorblind twice in every video. Because I know, because instead of having to people message me and tell me, it's easier for me to just say I am. And when you get in your 40s, which I'm about to be 46 in December, you say things twice to people, maybe three times. So that's just the way it goes. And you learn to, I know this guy's name and I can't remember. He's one of my favorites because again, he reminds me, you know, it's like a perfect cross. And, you know, I've never talked to Mark about like, what his inspirations were. I mean, but to me, a lot of that early stuff he did is like a perfect cross between American 50s sci-fi and Japanese kaiju from the 70s. That's what it reminds me of, like a perfect cross. Even some Captain Ultra looking stuff, which I'm not saying, I mean, we all from our, you know, imagination drag this stuff up, but you know, there's always that inspiration. I have it too, you know. I'll make a figure and I'm like, that's so original. And you know, like nothing like this is out there ever. And then, you know, you post it and some guy says, oh, that looks like so-and-so character from that movie. And I'm like, oh my God. And I punch it in. Well, it sure does. Heck, I didn't know that. That's just the way it goes. But, you know, when you're creative, it just comes out of all orifices. Anyway, can't remember that guy's name, but he's top shelf stuff. Here he is again. This is a Max Toy Club exclusive. I didn't even actually know he had a toy club or I'd have joined it. But anyway, I love that one because I guess, yeah, he's glow in the dark and got gold on him and everything else like that. And it's be hard for me to sell any of these. I like them so much, to be honest with you. I guess I could You could always sell one or two and keep the rest, you know. Here's one in a bag that's giving me trouble. Look at that dude. I like the little ones because they're all hulking. You know, they have the big upper body and they're all hulking and pink and green. Pink and green is a deadly combo, man. I love that color mix there. Let's see if we got any more Max toy in here. Say the truth, I lose train of thought. That's one. I can't love that thing. Love. Yeah, that has definitely Baragon written all over it, but man, it's just like a ultra super duper, way better than Baragon actually. You know, if you're talking in essential kaiju terms, you know, way better. Because I go through boxes and I switch them up and stuff like that, like sometimes I show multiples of things that I don't realize it. Well, anyway, okay. I think that's most of the Max toy that's in here. This is the Heteron Brothers. You know, that's a glow one. I got lots of these. I'm real partial to them. Made by Gargamel. Yep, Gargamel. I'm having a pretty good day. I guess I've worked so hard, it's like cleared my head or something. So I'm having a good day remembering some of these names. Never can remember these guys' names, but I know that this prolific maker makes a lot of them. Well-known kaiju maker. Always has that big head, small body, a lot of times that arm. I love it. I think very creative, very good. Man, I don't know what this is. You can't even hardly see it because it's so black. But man, it's pretty neat. It's got tubes and orifices everywhere. Anyway. But yeah, but probably the busiest time of my life I'm going through right now. It's like a, at 45, a resurgence I wish I had the energy resurgence, but man, I got the drive right now like I've never had in my life, to be honest with you. I mean, I've always had a lot of drive, but I got a lot of drive right now. Anyway, there's a Bullmark reproduction. I know they call them Asteron, and I think call them Asteron anyway. These are small guys. Most of these are small guys. That's why they're in this small tub. There's a bear model, and I don't remember that monster, but man, that's pretty. You know, I mean, that you get pretty. I mean, that again, well, pink and green, purple and green, it does the same thing to me. Shit, I could be wrong on the colors. Bear model little guys, which are really, really cool. Glow in the dark. Jamila, Namagon. Crazy, I can remember all this stuff. Like, I have a really hard time remembering. I was on one of these videos one time and I held up a Baltan, speaking of, and I don't know what, he's like Blomo. He's not a bootleg, but that's weird. He's got Bullmark and he does not feel vinyl. He feels like he's a polypropylene Blomo. Anyway, whatever, there he is. Anyway, I could not remember Baltan, Alien Baltan's name. That was crazy, because that used to be my favorite. Of all the Ultraman monsters, and you know, sorry y'all, been outside, been working. We bought a bunch of shop equipment, or I bought a bunch of shop equipment. My partners ain't here yet, so it's all me building everything. So they'll be here soon enough, and I'll have them some chores. Heteron, which with the killer, love these guys. I have a bazillion. Really ridiculous how many of the different colors and stuff I have. And I love the header card, you know. Shoot, I couldn't sell that based on header alone. Here is one of those really cool sets that Marmot did of it. Yeah, Marmot. And it's got all the Godzilla guys and aliens and, let's see, you can see him better. These are pretty tough to get if I'm just not mistaken. I can't remember. But anyway, I got a good 1965 Toho. These were made in 2003. So anyway, really cool stuff. There's another one of those guys. 2007. I just cannot remember the name of the man that makes all these, but they're really good. Really, really, really good figures. There's another one like it, you know. I like these little ones because, you know, they're inexpensive and for vinyl. And they just, they have a look, you know, like a squattiness that I just love. Gotta be my favorite U-Tom of all time. Love him. And it's a repop of the original, I'm sure. Yeah, it's a repop of the original. But man, with that metallic spray and everything. It's not original.
You never know.
Finger puppet. Head or finger puppet by Marmot. That's staying with me for life.
Or death.
Might do a pyramid. I think I can build a pyramid. I'd be buried in, throw quite a few toys in there. I wouldn't want to take away my kids' inheritance, but you know, it would just be cool. You know, I know you can't take it with you for real, but you know what'd be cool is if somebody grave robbed you. Like sometimes, like if you built a pyramid, put all your good stuff in there, a bunch of good stuff, and then just the fact that it's so juicy in there that people can't resist but to come and grave rob, that'd be pretty cool. I mean, as long as it wasn't some crackhead, that would suck. But maybe like a true grave robber, you know, Indiana Jones's type person in the future. Yeah. Or do those still exist? I don't even know. I would do that. Now, I would never rob a grave. Take it back. There you go. I would never rob nothing. But it's a good thought. Okay. I don't know who that is. Totally in love with that figure. Totally. Don't even have no clue. From the yokai, the ghost people deal. Love that dude. I don't know what brand he is. I don't know. Love this thing. I don't know who makes it. It's all in Japanese, but it looks like a tadpole, right? And it's got a eye and it's glow in the dark. Love that thing. Don't need to know. See, that's what I tell people. Get off your tunnel vision, your closed-mindedness, man. See it, like it, look at it. Oh man, quit thinking of yourself as a toy collector. Think of yourself as an art connoisseur. That's what I honestly do. I think of myself as, man, a good seer of when it's all put together and it really looks art, you know, like good art, you know, because this art's better than most art, toy art, man, comic books. That's better than most art ever has been, ever will be, to be honest with you. It means something to us. It touches us in ways that fine art can never touch us. You know, maybe there was a time period when fine art did that for most people, but dude, we're a different generation. This is our stuff, you know? Love that dude. Don't gotta know what it is, just know I love it. That's the way I look at it. That is the way I must look at it. Gargamel, yeah. They made this figure, you know, like back in the early 70s, and this is a reprint of it. It's like a junk tire monster. It's got a truck on top, a junk truck. And then tires and cars for feet. That's a good monster. I like garbage monsters. There's something about it, you know. I guess I've been around a lot of garbage, and I just kind of like garbage or junk or whatever. Don't ask me what this is. It's vinyl, and it is on it. It's a tank, and it's got a little pudgy, fat, little weird guy on top of the tank. Again, have no idea, but how could you not love it? I love it. I love lots of stuff. That is a cause for trouble, as well as having a nice collection, too. Oh, look at this guy. 2006. Who made this? Bullmark. And check it out. A little baby Godzilla, which I don't like baby Godzilla, but I like this guy. I like the sculpt. I like the look. Look at that little dude. He's red. They did a good job on that. This is a tag, right? Weird tag on the neck. Anyway, oh, hey, this is Max Toy. Wow, look at that thing. I don't ever remember seeing that before. I haven't, so I mean, I have seen it, but you know what I mean. Isn't that cool? Sorry, I'm looking. Here is a Marmot Toho, a little green Baragon. That's legit cool, right? Some of these, I used to hate solid color stuff that wasn't painted, you know? Now I really see the aesthetic in it, you know? I like it. Here's a finger puppet. Oh, for little fingers. Frankenstein conquers the world. Anyway, always cool. Love me a good finger puppet. Finger puppets are my thing, y'all kind of know that. I think I've said that a million times. But anyway, so, I mean, yeah, there's some scattered little, actually there's little tiny Buta no Hana figures in here, but they're tiny, tiny, and I don't think they'll really show up on camera. One day I think I'm gonna get a camera and I'm gonna focus it down on the table and I'm gonna, like, where I can really go real close up and show you, because I have boxes and boxes and box tubs and tubs and tubs full of little tiny monsters from Japan and Italy and all over the world. So anyway, that's the plan. Anyway, I might make another video. I'm not sure. I got so much stuff to do and I don't have a lot of time, so we'll see, but I'll do it. Anyway, thanks y'all for watching again. Victory!